the fastball is going the way of the dodo, disco, and my diet, cookies. Joining us now to discuss some of the reasons why, the television and radio voices of the Detroit Tigers, Mario Mpemba and Dan Dickerson. Mario, we've always believed that a pitcher bases everything off his fastball. Is that really no longer the case?
Well, first of all, we've been referred to as dodos up here, both of us.
No, I wasn't speaking of you.
But anyway, Mick, yeah, it sure seems like it. You know, we just completed a four-game series last week against the Cleveland Indians, saw guys like Kluber and Carrasco and Tomlin and Bauer, and they just gave the Tigers a steady diet of breaking balls all series long. Now, the New York Yankees have the highest, fastest average fastball in the league, yet they throw it the fewest times. They got flamethrowers like Chapman, Canley, Betances, and Larry Rothschild, their pitching coach, says the reason we do it, big league hitters now can catch up to the fastball, and so we are adapting. And that's why, even though they've got flamethrowers, Mick, on that roster, they are now throwing more breaking balls, changeups. That just seems to be the way the game's going.
Dan, have you noticed the same things?
Yeah, I think the Yankees have really led this revolution. The Houston Astros certainly got in on it in the last couple of years. But if you go back 4, 5, 6 years, the Yankees have always been at the very bottom of the American League in terms of how often they throw their fastball. I think the thing that matters, Mario, and we've seen Toronto in that same time go from using their fastball the most on a team basis to the least.
Yeah.
It does depend on the pitchers you have on the staff. It gets back to a lot of the analytics in terms of how do you spin the ball? Is that your best pitch? If it's your best pitch, use it, but not everybody has guys who can spin the ball and spin it well. And if you notice, guys, the league average in terms of how often a fastball is used, pretty much unchanged. What we're seeing is at the extremes, like the Yankees, it has dropped remarkably. A hard-throwing staff spinning the ball down at 4 out of every 10 pitches for a fastball, that's an incredible change in the last 5, 6 years.
You know, I think when you see guys like Max Scherzer and Clayton Kershaw and Justin Verlander and Gerrit Cole and some of your hardest-throwing starters in the major leagues, when you see their numbers at the end of the day and their readings are less than 50%, that tells me that this is going to be around baseball for a number of years. You go back to the World Series last year, the youngster McCullers of the Houston Astros threw 54 pitches in the series, and 41 of those were breaking balls. We've watched Chris Bosio with this particular staff, and make no mistake about it, it's why these guys' numbers are so much better. They're not throwing fastballs and fastball counts. They're throwing breaking balls and breaking ball counts. And another thing, Dan, you mentioned analytics. A lot of times they know they're not going to face the lineup the third time through, so they're going to use their best pitches for that 75 or 80 that they have during the course of the game.
Pitchers are throwing fewer strikes, yet strikeouts are not down. Dan, do you think it's only a matter of time before the hitters wise up, or are they being outfoxed by the pitchers right now?
It's always cyclical. There's always an adjustment. Think about how more and more we know that with the swing adjustment that hitters are making with launch angle, the high fastball now is going to be used more and more against some of those guys to get them out, try to get them out up in the strike zone. There will be a reaction by hitters. The one thing to watch is you're already hearing, well, walk rates are up, so maybe hitters are already adjusting and recognizing pitches. It's all about recognizing pitches and laying off those pitches out of the strike zone. So walk rates are up. I would caution, in April, it's really hard
right
to make adjustment or to make any kind of conclusions about whether hitters are already doing it, because guys are having a tough time gripping the ball in cold weather. You can rarely make any conclusions about April, but I do think you will see hitters make the adjustment. Today's starting pitcher is a good example, Mario. Francisco Liriano has always gotten guys out of the strike zone, but in the last 2 years, more and more opposing hitters against Francisco Liriano are laying off his pitches out of the strike zone.
Yeah, I would agree with that. And I think Dan touched on one thing. They always are making adjustments. And we talked to Chris Bosio on the air during spring training and saying, Boz, with the launch angle craze now, is the elevated fastball the way to counteract that? And Boz says, absolutely. That's the way the game goes. There are constantly adjustments being made. And, you know, I think Dan's right. I think we'll continue to see adjustments on the other side.
You know, one of the things also, as far as the launch angle is concerned, and Mario brings up a great point, that's where the curveball starts at one level, then it ends up at another level, and guys are simply swinging over the top of it. But I do think that some adjustments will be made.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how this kind of develops over the course of the season. It's been fascinating so far, just like watching Mario and Dan every chance we get. Thank you, guys. Have a
Thanks,
good
guys.
One. Have a good one today. All right.